visit www.davernoise.com. Without further ado, after the long explanation of who we are about to see, I present to you Tris Callahan.
Everyone, we are Tris Kelly. This is Vicki Reed, Katie Chilton, Mary Belmar, and myself, Marge Telfer. And we're here to sing for you some American hymns and parlor songs, some of which were possibly known and sung by people in this house. Most of the songs we'll sing for you date from the mid-1800s, although a few are earlier, and one or two are early 20th century. Please relax and enjoy, and if any of the songs are familiar to you, feel free to sing along. Thank you.
Faith on earth and stable land, a higher plane than I have found. I will bow and be simple.
Dave in the next song is Down to the River to Pray, good old gospel song. Hope you enjoy.
As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down to the river to pray.
Together, he wrote about 6,500 texts for different hymns. Considered to be Wesley's finest hymn, Jesus, Lover of My Soul, was written in 1738. First thought to be too sentimental, it did not become popular until after Wesley's death in 1788. Several legends surround its writing. One relates it to a violent storm at sea while Wesley was sailing back to England from America. Whatever the inspiration, it has continued to touch people's hearts down through the ages. Consider the following story, and this is a true story. During the Civil War, a Confederate courier named Levi Hefner was sent by General Robert E. Lee to take a message through an area occupied by Union troops. As he neared a bridge, his horse balked. Hefner dismounted and tried to calm the horse. In the darkness, Hefner began singing softly an old familiar hymn, Jesus, Lover of My Soul. In a few minutes, the horse quieted, and Hefner was able to mount, cross the bridge, and safely complete his mission. A number of years later, after the war, Hefner attended a reunion of soldiers from both sides. They gathered in small groups to share their experiences from the war. A Union soldier from Ohio told the story. He remembered standing around on guard one dark night at a bridge. His orders had been to shoot anyone approaching from the opposite side. During the night, only one rider came his way, and he raised his rifle to shoot as soon as he could see the form in the darkness. He saw the horse balk and the rider dismount. To calm the horse, the rider began softly singing, Jesus, Lover of My Soul. The Union soldier told the circle of old soldiers that the sound of the hymn so touched him that he lowered his rifle and backed away into the darkness. He said, "I could not shoot him." Levi Hefner, who was in the circle of listeners, jumped up and embraced the Union soldier, saying, "That was me." And he realized for the first time that his singing that night had saved his life.
Oh,
you just heard, set to a different tune.
Thank you. join with them who've gone before. I am bound for the land of Cain, where sin and sorrows are no more. I am bound for the land of Cain. Oh, Cain, bright Cain, I am bound for the land of Cain. Oh, Cain, and it is my happy home. I am bound for the land of Cain. Our songs of praise shall fill the skies. I am bound for the land of Cain. And higher still our joys they rise. I am bound for the land of Cain. Oh, Cain, bright Cain, I am bound for the land of Cain. Oh, Cain, and it is my happy home. I am bound for the land of Cain.
Nearly over, I like to go down and watch all the
with the doctors and merchants and lawyers. Their manners are fine, but their feet are of clay. And there's none that with the style of my law driver. For he goes burling down and down the white water. That's where the law driver learns to step lightly. It's burling down and down the white water. The law driver's waltz pleases girls completely.
Chances with all sorts of men, but none is so fine as my lad on the river. So when the drive's over, if he asks me again, I think I will marry my log driver.
For he goes further and down the white water. That's where the log driver learns to step lightly. It's further and down the white water. The log driver's waltz pleases girls completely.
Deep and solemn roar. Alleluia, alleluia,
much again for inviting us. You made us feel wonderful and so welcome. This is a great place. Doesn't matter if we've got a small crowd. I mean, it was. Well,
I think you're way better than football.
Dave over there, son of Wendy. Yeah. And Bill, who is a great man and also our video coach. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We're very proud to have had you here with us tonight, and you're just phenomenal. So, very, very pleased to
have you. Does that mean we can come back?
Yes.
As long as I don't have to beg, because I'm about to. But, so yes, we would love that very much. Upcoming events in the next couple of weeks. On Sunday, the 13th of November, our second Sunday lecture is Brian Fox Ellis telling stories of the Civil War, ghosts, and legends. And then our next Music at the Mansion series will be on Friday, the 18th of November, with Lyric Winds. That's Sue Gillio, Gene Montgomery, Ben Crosby, and Terry McTaggart. Also coming up the first weekend of November, our advisory board seminar, which is a 3-day long seminar of lectures and music and wonderfulness. And that will be starting on Friday the 4th of November through the 3rd. It is reservation only, so you'll need to call the office for that. And then a Hector Karras Christmas, directed by our very own Tricia Kelly, will be taking place on December 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. With performances at 4 p.m. and at 3 p.m. on the 4th. So we hope to see all of you and our new friends as well coming to some of these events soon. With that, I'll bid you all good night, and thank you very much for coming. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.